speaking of red tide, Bob, you know, not the best conditions. Mm, they no. seem to have come back a little bit.
A little bit, yeah, in some areas. And it's patchy again. And with the west wind we've seen, it does cause a little bit more problem. And we are still getting reports of red tide offshore as well.
Right.
And unfortunately, that looks like it's not going away anytime soon. We could, again, use a little bit more wave action around to kick things up a bit and disperse that red tide. That would help. Red tide, not a factor tonight for this particular webcam. This is well away from it, but this is from our ABC, actually the Van Wezel webcam, showing the nice sunset tonight. Just a little bit of clouds off in the distance. Someone said they claimed to have seen the green flash, the famous green flash, the flash of green right below the, as the sun goes below the horizon. No photos sent in, but some photos of the sunset and some towering cumulonimbus clouds developing just around sunset, looking to our south. This from Norm Schimmel. And Norm, Venice, Susanna gets this a little closer up near the Venice jetty of those storms. And now those storms are bringing rainfall closer to home. Those were down south near Fort Myers and Punta Gorda earlier. They're now into South Sarasota County. And moving off to the west, we have some in the east of Sarasota as well in Manatee County. Although this line is weakening somewhat, there's still a chance some of this could hold together here and push off to the west. Right now, that rain is slowly coming to an end near Englewood. It's pretty heavy earlier, some lightning there. And also near Northport, starting to wind down as it heads toward Venice and the Venetian. Look for a pretty good light show offshore with water temperatures in the upper 80s there. We're going to see those storms maybe fire up a little bit more as they head out to the west. Some rain just to the west of Warren Mineral Springs. Near Myakka City, Myakka Head pushing off to the west. Now, if they do hold together, these will be the times that they may have an impact on your neighborhood. I don't think it's going to go to everyone here, but if we do, it will be a little late. Actually, 1:44 in the morning, we could see some rain near Bradenton. Well, they're seeing the rain now. It's heavy, too. The system itself, Florence, is now just a remnant low, bringing some moderate to heavy rainfall at times across parts of Pennsylvania, especially into Virginia tonight. As I mentioned earlier, a tornado moved through Richmond, Virginia, killing one and injuring another. This is another system that we're keeping an eye on. But good news, this is being sheared apart, and the Hurricane Center gives it no chance of developing over the next 5 days. Now, you can see that area is just a broad area of low pressure now. Some heavy rain, though, in Jamaica and up toward the eastern tip of Cuba. Now, the actual remnants, though, will spread off to the west and northwest, we do believe, in time. So even if it were to pop up or something were to develop here in the Gulf of Mexico, it doesn't appear that it would have much of a problem hitting us because we have high pressure that's building in. Now, as far as the season goes, it's been fairly active. In reality, we've had 10 named storms and 5 tropical storms, 5 hurricanes, with one major hurricane being Florence, Category 4 hurricane. Now, what we are looking for, if you look at the normal kind of season, from September 17th through the end, there's usually 5 more storms, one major hurricane. And if we were to see 5 more storms, it would be considered an active hurricane season. So we'll see how it goes. But the next name is Kirk, followed by Leslie, and then Michael. Well, some dry air and upper level low spinning right here. Not a concern as far as the tropics go, but we do have this dry air in place just to the east of the Bahamas. It's going to stay there, too, I think. It's going to kind of wrap around this low pressure area off into the distance there. Temperatures are into the 80s. It's warm. There's still plenty of heat for these storms to develop, but we are expecting low temperatures to be a little bit above average. The forecast looks like this. For us tomorrow, we'll see showers scattered about in the afternoon and evening, and then pushing off toward the west late in the afternoon and evening. Now, the current conditions, we have 83. Feels like 91 out there. The high today warmed to 90, just 1 degree above average. So for boaters tomorrow, looks like this. Winds will be out of the east-southeast, switching to the west-northwest, and a light chop on the bays and inland waters. The extended forecast, a slight chance for late-day storms tomorrow. And we get into that afternoon and evening pattern through Friday. Saturday, not as many, but still a chance for a few scattered storms. Jacqueline?
Bob, thank you.